Welcome to LANDR Composer, the all-in-one intelligent plugin designed to provide instant harmonic ideas, helping you build a solid foundation to your tracks. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use LANDR Composer, walking you through every element to get the most out of this powerful plugin. Let's get started. In LANDR Composer, you have control over four main elements of music: the chords, the bass, the arpeggio, as well as the melody. You can add each one of them by pressing the plus sign just right here. So I can add the bass, the melody, and the arpeggio, and I have a full sonic arrangement. The chords module is like the brain of the plugin that feeds the harmonic information into the other modules. Whatever you change there will automatically be changed in those other modules, which we'll get into later in this video. The bass module will create a bass line that follows the chord progression. The melody module will create a simple or complex melody that'll also complement the notes in the chord progression. And the arpeggio module arpeggiates the notes in different ways that also follows the chord progression. With each module, I can either solo or mute them depending on what I want to hear. So if I want to hear just the chords, I can press that. Or if I want to hear the whole thing without the bass, I'll just press the mute button. It's important to note that you can have more than one of each module if you want to compare different ideas. So for example, I had two arpeggios. I can create an idea here or here and solo and mute them and select one to go with. Looking at the top of the plugin, you'll see the main transport controls. DAW sync makes it so that the plugin syncs with your DAW. This is especially important if you're working with something like vocals and you want to hear those chord progressions over top of the vocals in your timeline. By turning off DAW sync, you'll just hear the plugin on its own without your DAW playing. Here's with it off, and then if I turn it on, I can press play in my DAW, and you'll see that the transport of the plugin follows the transport of the DAW. Next to the DAW sync button is the generate chords button. Now you'll see this depending on where it is in the plugin, and the context changes depending on where it is. So for example, if I press this here, it's going to generate chords in the timeline for me across this scene. And if I have multiple scenes here, which we'll get into a bit later by pressing the plus button, it'll also generate chords for that scene. So you can see I have these chords now, and if I press the generate button, I have different chords for each scene. And of course, you can always undo or redo any changes that you've made. So for example, if I liked those chord progressions that I had earlier, I'll just go back and cycle through. And finally, you have the skip button, which will bring you back to the beginning of the chord progression. I tend to use this when DAW sync is off if I want to control the transport within the plugin so I can demo out chord progressions. You have start, stop, as well as a master fader that'll control the master volume of the plugin. Next, let's look at scenes. Scenes are great for holding chord progressions that'll occur in different sections of a song. To add a scene, all I have to do is press the plus button here, and I can add up to four scenes. So for example, I can have the first scene be my intro, I have scene two as my verse, scene three as my bridge, and scene four as my chorus. To delete scenes, all you have to do is right click and press the trash icon. You can also duplicate scenes if you want those chords to appear again in another scene by pressing the duplicate button, and you can insert scenes after one another by pressing the insert scene button. You can also drag around scenes. Let's say I want scene four to go first, I can drag it over here, and scene three to go last, I can do that as well. By pressing the song mode button next to the add scene button, you have the option to play through all of the scenes sequentially. So it'll play from the start, and then it'll go through each scene. This is great if you want to demo all of the chords within each scene together. So you can see the progress bar up here on each scene as it's playing through. Then if I disable that, I have the option to just demo the chords within each scene and it'll repeat itself. Every time you select a scene, you'll see the main controls to the right of the plugin with the actions that we've already covered. So we have delete, duplicate, and insert scene as well. What's new here is that you can select the key. So I have all 12 keys here. I can select the scale, and this is for each scene. So if I want Lydian in scene three, copy one, that's going to be in Lydian, and the chords generated will be in that scale. I can also select the length. So I can select 4, 5, 6, 7, as many bars as I want for each scene, as well as the time signature. And what you can also do is select a chord progression from the chord progression bank. So if you click here, you'll see a bunch of chord progressions organized by emotion or mood. And that's really cool if you want to browse through chord progressions instead of randomly generating them. You can also highlight your favorites by just clicking the heart icon right here. Now let's look at the progression lane. This is where I can add new chords to my scene. So I can press the plus sign here and I'll add a new chord. I can shift around the chords by clicking, holding, and dragging. I can even adjust where they play. So let's say I want this A minor chord to only play for half the bar. I can just drag this over. And let's say I want this last A minor chord to play at the end of the progression. I can just click, hold, and drag. By selecting each chord, you'll see that the right-hand panel changes. This is where I can select the quality of the chord. So for example, if I want this C major chord to be a minor chord, I can just select that here. If I want to add any embellishments or extensions, like a 7, a 9, or 11, I can select those here. And I can change the inversion of the chord. So let's say I want it to be in first inversion, I can go there. And you'll see all of the options change. So you can see the melodies changing based on my selections. By clicking on the Generate Chord button, I can generate a new chord for each chord slot by just clicking here, and it'll generate a chord in that scale that'll work in this progression. So I can just cycle through, I can demo it, and I can generate again or add any customization to each chord. Now let's get into the sound of the plugin. So by clicking on each track, you'll see the sound panel open up on the right-hand side. It's here where you can adjust the sound. So for this chord track, I can generate new settings and it'll automatically choose a preset that'll work well for chords. So I can do this and you can see it's shifting around different presets, keys, pads, plucks. You'll see if I go to the bass, I can generate new settings based on the bass presets that are included. So I can generate and you'll see that the sound preset down here is changing. Now, if I ever want to go in and select my own preset, I can just open up the sound preset panel, and then I can go and demo each of these. So to select an arpeggio sound, what I'll do is I'll solo out the arpeggios, and I'll go to the sound preset panel here, I'll press play, and I can select different sounds based on how it sounds. And of course, you can adjust the volume and the pan for each module. So I can go through my chords. Maybe I want that to come down. I can go to my melody, I can bring that up a bit. Maybe my arpeggios, I want to come in on the right. It's great for sketching out ideas and seeing what the final result might be before you export the MIDI, which we'll get into a bit later. Finally, let's get into the chord clip and MIDI performance. By clicking on each of these chord clips here, you'll see the performance box pop in on the right. This is where I can select rhythmic rules. So for example, on my arpeggio, if I just want a note on every eighth note, I can select that here and you'll see it change here. If I want this arpeggio to become a polyrhythm, I can select a time signature here. So let's say I want 5/4 arpeggio. It's going to give me an arpeggio that's 5 beats long. And if my progression is 4 beats long, I'll get a cool polyrhythm happening. Below, you'll see 6 parameters that you can adjust for the melody, arpeggios, and bass modules. And then for the chord modules, you have 4 parameters that you can adjust. Let's get into those. So in the chords module, you have polyphony, which is the number of voices per chord. So if I bring that down, you can see that adjust here. So if I want 2 voices per chord, and I can go all the way up to 6, depending on what chord you select. If I select spread, I can bring that up and it's gonna shift the notes to be further away from each other, which is great if you want a more spread out MIDI performance. Strum is gonna strum the MIDI, similar to like if a guitar player was playing it, so I can increase that and you can hear the chords being strummed. So I'll just solo this out. It's really great if you want an expressive sound to your MIDI. And finally, we have octave, which just sets the MIDI to a specific octave. So you want the sounds to be lower, you can go low. And if you want the sounds to be higher, you can go up high. You can always click generate new performance if you want to get more of a randomized performance on all of these modules. So I can go here, click generate, and you'll see the parameters change. If you want to generate a new performance, but not change one of the parameters, you can select this lock button here. And it'll actually lock the parameter from being changed. So if that's locked, I can click generate new performance and you'll see that my strum is not being changed. Now let's take a look at the performance panel for the melody and arpeggio modules. So I have melody pulled up here. I have the density, which adjusts the number of notes per bar. So I can drag that down if I want it to be a bit more simple. And I can drag it up if I want more notes per bar. For complexity, I can actually adjust how much rhythm I'd like per bar. So if I drag that all the way down, it's going to make it really simple rhythmically. And if I drag it up all the way up, it'll make it a bit more complex. The variation actually adjusts the amount of variation of the musical phrases. So if I drag that up, you'll see different variations appear within the melody. This is great if you have like a scene that you have a certain melody, you can copy that over to another scene and then just adjust the variation. Then you get sort of a similar melody, but not quite the same. Obviously, polyphony increases the number of voices. So if you want a melody with two voices, three, and it almost becomes like your chord track, but a bit different because you have some melodic ideas happening. Silence inserts silence at the beginning or the end of the MIDI. So if I go this way, you'll see silence being inserted at the beginning. And if I go this way, you'll see silence being inserted at the end. And this is great for adding breathing room to your MIDI phrases here. And we have octaves, same as the chords, it'll adjust the octave that the MIDI is playing in. With arpeggios, you'll see the exact same parameters here. So we have the same density, complexity, variation, polyphony, silence, and octave, which will do the same thing to your arpeggio, a bit different than the melody, but it's going to carry the same function. Now moving on to bass, you'll see one of the parameters change. So we have the same as the other two, but we have this humanized parameter, and that just adds a bit more of a human feel. So it'll move the MIDI off the grid just a little bit to give it more human feel, right? So I can adjust the density, and I'll just go here to humanize. And if we bring this up and just zoom in a little bit, you can see the notes just shifting off the grid a little bit, giving the performance a bit of a more organic feel. Now that I have this opened up, it's a good moment to talk about the actual chord clip. So you can double click anything and you'll see this MIDI editor, and this behaves like any standard MIDI editor. I can select notes, I can move them around, I can make them shorter or longer. So I can go like this and just make this one shorter. And I can adjust the velocities of each note, so I can bring this one down. If I ever want to get out of this MIDI editor, I just click the close button down at the bottom left-hand side. And finally, if you're happy with the MIDI performance, you can easily drag it out of the plugin into your session by just clicking and dragging from the performance box, and you'll find the click and drag button here on each clip. This is great, so you can use it with any third-party plugins or virtual instruments in your DAW. And that's it. I hope this video was helpful in understanding how to use LANDR Composer. Since using it, I found it incredibly helpful to start tracks from arrangement to finishing them. And I know it'll help you too. Thanks for watching.